Hi everyone, Jonas here. Hope I don't lose you now, but today we're actually gonna talk about ethics. I know, not one of the sexier topics in this industry, but if you're into wildlife filmmaking or photography for that matter, this is stuff that you should know. Have you heard the story of how huge numbers of lemmings may commit mass suicide by jumping off of a cliff into the ocean? This is something that I was taught as a kid, and I know for a fact that I'm not alone because I've talked to people all over the world that were taught this when they were kids. And I sincerely hope that this is not taught to kids anymore, because this whole fact was based on a false claim that was shown in a nature documentary produced by Disney, actually, in the 1950s. The myth that they jumped off a cliff and committed mass suicide is actually older than this documentary, but it was later revealed that the footage from the documentary was from lemmings being forced off of the cliff by the film crew. As wildlife filmmakers and photographers, we have a big public responsibility. Much of what the public learns about the natural world comes from creators like us. And if we want to continue being able to do what we do, we should probably also do what we can to make sure wild places remain, right? Fortunately, organizations like the BBC or Filmmakers for Conservation have created a list of kind of recommendations of how we should behave when we're out shooting wildlife documentary stuff. Here's a simple summary of some of the points that we need to consider and why. Number one, always put the welfare of the subject that we're filming above all else. This really summarizes everything, and it does make sense when you say it, but it is important to remind yourself of this when all of the craziness of a shoot actually starts. And this leads us into point number two. Ensure that your subjects are not caused any physical harm, anxiety, consequential predation, or lessened reproductive success by your activities. Animals do get stressed too, and the stress can lead to things like decreased reproductive success, something that we can't see the effects of right away. One other thing is risk of spreading diseases. I spent a lot of time getting pictures of frogs, for example. Problem is that a lot of frogs are dying around the world because of a disease caused by what's called a chytrid fungus. Knowing this, before you go to a place, you can help prevent spreading the issue between areas by cleaning your gear and cleaning your boots. Stuff like this is really important as we move between natural areas. Number three, don't do anything that will permanently alter the natural behavior of your subjects. Let's say a bear learns the connection between humans and food. Pretty cool at first, because you'll see the bear and you can get pictures of it. But that bear may soon have to be removed from the temptation of searching for food around people, and most often, that means that we are forced to kill it. Number four, it is unacceptable to restrict or restrain an animal by any means to attract a predator. What can I say? Hopefully this speaks for itself. Number five, subjects should never be drugged or restrained in order to alter their behavior for the sole purpose of filming. This is also a no-brainer, but to put it in context, I've heard of times when venomous snakes, wild snakes, have been cooled down so much that they can get manhandled in front of the camera with no energy to strike back. Not cool. This, of course, shouldn't be confused with researchers where animals have to be drugged for tagging or measurement purposes. A lot of times we document their work, which is to gain a better understanding of the animal and the behavior, with an ultimate goal of benefiting that animal. Number six, be aware of and follow all local and national laws regarding wildlife where you are filming. It may feel annoying sometimes, like not being able to fly your drone in areas like national parks and stuff, but we have to remind ourselves that for most of the time, it is for the benefit of the environment and the animals in it. Number seven, images or script that give an audience abnormal, misleading, or false information about a subject or behavior should be avoided. Like the story of the lemmings, for example. Another related topic that is often discussed today is filming captive animals and pretending it was shot in the wild. If I, for example, post a picture like this and talk about my epic and dangerous encounter with a huge grizzly bear, I would be straight up lying even if it looks about right. In reality, it was a fun photo session day out with the awesome Casey Anderson and his bear Brutus. If you haven't checked them out, by the way, you really have to. They're awesome. But with a shot like this, I could easily paint a false picture of grizzly bears if I wanted to. But that would just be misleading and wrong. Lastly, what it comes down to, always research your subject prior to filming. Not only will it help tell the story better, it will also help you understand signs of stress or other problems and reduce the risk of potential dangers that could happen. That was a summary of some of the points. And just one more thing, everyone. Let's make sure that we clean up after ourselves when we're out there. I personally hate seeing trash in nature. I mean, the key thing here is that we all love getting cool shots of the natural world, but it is called wildlife for a reason. So let's do what we can to keep it that way. A lot of the support that we get through our Patreon page goes straight into telling stories from the natural world and the work that scientists do to help protect it. So a big thank you to all of you guys supporting us through the Patreon page, and a big thank you to everyone else for watching this video, and stay tuned for the video coming out next week.